upcoming national TV schedule brought to you by ESPN Bet. Well, it's no longer if necessary. NBA Finals Game 5 from Boston on Monday night at the TD Garden on ABC. Tip off shortly after 8:30. And then Wednesday, June 26th, NBA Draft first round and the second round on the 27th. A lot of big plays as we listen to Daniel Gafford mic'd up. Walsh drives in, shot won't go. Batted around. It's just you think about with Gafford, and just made so many big plays early. With Gafford and PJ Washington to go from the teams that were two of the worst teams in the NBA to now in the NBA Finals. What a rejuvenation. Just changes everything. Gafford said, he goes, the vibe in my life is different.
Hard not to be happy when you're playing in the NBA Finals, but across the board for the Dallas Mavericks tonight, the intensity, the force, the mindset was different. I assume there will be a carryover in mindset for them in Game 5. There will be a test in mindset for the Boston Celtics coming off this game.
Well, can they keep game pressure on? Can they keep it close in Boston with two of the game's great closers? Kyrie Irving would love another opportunity to get to the TD Garden, perhaps have a typical Kyrie Irving night, which he's yet to do in that building.
But two excellent games here in Dallas, 35, and a whistle and a foul. 21 tonight, didn't have to do much the way the game had gone, 21-6. Only had to play 31 minutes, Doncic only 32 minutes. Meanwhile, the starters for the Celtics, Brown just 27, Tatum 27, Joe Mazzulla taking his starters out in the third quarter. None of them played in the fourth.
None of them were sharp. I can think about Jrue Holiday, who hadn't had a turnover in the finals and had, I believe, five tonight.
Morris lost it out of bounds. What he said at the top, will the Mavericks play with desperation or resignation? Man, right from the opening tip, led by Doncic, he set the tone in the opening minutes. As JJ, as you said earlier, the bench really did a great job. As the set hits the three-pointer. One of the most lopsided NBA Finals games we've ever seen. The largest margin of victory ever in a finals game is 42. That's Chicago over Utah. The Jazz scored 54 points in that game. Hey, Morris got it. He's taking some shots. He wanted one to go. He was 0 for 4. By the way, that Chicago-Utah game back in 1998. Here in the final minute, some of the crowd, select few heading for the exits. Most of them want to stand and cheer. Don't forget, Dallas has been very, very good on the road in the playoffs. 7-4 away from the American Airlines Center. Had those big victories in Minnesota, in Oklahoma City, and in Los Angeles against the Clippers. Much deserved standing ovation from this crowd. The Celtics hope for their 18th championship will have to wait another day. This is a veteran team that has seen all the highs and lows. They'll be confident they'll bounce back, especially at the TD Garden. Well, the Dallas Mavericks, they're still alive. It's a huge hill to climb. Well, they got the one they needed to keep their season alive and have a Game 5 in Boston on Monday night. A spectacular dominant performance from Luka Doncic and the Mavericks.
third largest margin of victory in finals history. And they did it at both ends of the floor, 122 points. And defensively held the Celtics to 36% shooting, out-rebounded by 21. Some of the numbers, obviously, the blowout, a little crazy. But it was dominant like that right from the start.
No question.